That's gone. Wow.
Toss it off. In the end zone. Caught. Touchdown.
Smolar goes right side. Michaela gets it to fall.
Wide open. He throws it home.
Good evening and welcome to Garden City High School, where today the Fordson Tractors invade the Cougar field today as Garden City comes in on this fourth game of the season with a 1-2 record. Fordson 1-2. I'm Ted Fordson along with Phil Henry, and we just had the kickoff.
Kicking the ball out of bounds by Garden City.
The ball on the 35-yard line, Phil. A contest is very important if you want playoff implications. You're 1-2. You can't afford to lose anymore.
Well, and not only that, but it's also a home game too, Ted. So it's really important for the Cougars right here. They've lost two in a row. They looked very impressive on the opening night against Ferndale with a victory. But then from then, it's been Romulus. And a loss to Romulus and then a loss to Thurston. So here they are against the Tractors. Tractors, very impressive last year. They're off to the same 1-2 start, Ted. So this is going to be a real interesting team against two evenly matched teams.
The Tractors come out, spread all over the field, hand the ball up the middle in the huge line. It's cross the 45, cross the 50, gets tackled around the 47-yard line for a big, huge 17-yard gain on the first play. As the Tractors immediately are coming up, Kassam Bedoin on the run. And Phil, you fill me in here. As Garden City is down three down linemen against this huge offensive line for the Tractors.
And this is Bedoin again, and he hops his way right up the middle, finding lots of real estate up the middle right now through the Cougars, Ted. They're taking the opening kickoff if you're joining us right now. There's no score in this game, and the Tractors are on the march right now. Two big runs by Kassam Bedoin as they've gone right, found a soft spot in the Cougar defense right up the middle, Ted.
And we have a spread. We have three receivers to the near side, one, so four receivers, two. The quarterback is in the shotgun. Is that number four quarterbacking there? 15
yes.
Was practicing earlier. Handoff again, skips and is tackled after a gain of two. So that's a big plus for the defense.
That was Sean Moore, the nose guard down there, Ted. 5'9", 200-pounder for Coach Murray, and did a nice job cutting inside the blocker right there. So that's the first play right there as they've held him to no gain. Brings up a big second down and nine.
And one of the down linemen jumped over, so that'll be a 5-yard penalty. Let me tell you what the Cougars up against tonight. The offensive line starting at left tackle is 255. 265, 265, 265, and the little guy at the right tackle is only 235. So there's
that ball,
a ton
foul,
of beef
ball
up there
on the center.
Fordson,
5-yard penalty.
Down. So.
Well, if you're Coach Murray in the company right now, I guess you're living under the mantra of the bigger they are, Ted, the harder they fall. So right now it's going backwards on a penalty against the Tractors. And there's the cheerleaders on this, and you can see spread formation.
Back
Elazad
pass,
back.
Three, four receivers out. The blitz is on. He evades one. Gets smothered at the 46-yard line for a loss of 6-7 on that play. And Fordson's going backwards.
Michael Trimble was in there to finish him up, but not before number 13 that we don't have listed down here on our sheet was in there also, Ted. Took three guys to slow him down, and a big loss right now as the Cougar defense is really stiffening after those opening two plays. And Hazim Elazat.
Elazat, the quarterback, is 5'10", 170 pounds. He's all alone in the backfield. Five receivers split all over the place. He's looking, he's dancing on the 40. He's in trouble. Steps across the 50, 45. Now he yanks it all alone at the 10-yard line. Evades one and number five, Mohamed Zarini, the wide receiver, scores a touchdown. And we have a penalty marker as the Zebras are at the 45-yard line, but he danced back there El-Zarad danced out there, and he had a receiver, Mohamed Zerini, all
illegal
alone
forward
at the 10.
Pass on the offense.
That's coming back, Ted. That was
It'll
a great
a
job of scrambling by El-Ziat as he really evaded a couple of the on-rushing Cougars right there and then left all alone. And sometimes on those broken plays, Ted, it's hard to cover everybody.
Well,
and Mohamed Serini was wide open at about the 8-yard line, reeled it in, put a nice move on the defender, scooted into the end zone, but it's all coming back.
Because what happened, Phil, is he threw that ball about the 43-yard line, the line of scrimmage, was the 46, so he was 3 yards behind the line of scrimmage when he threw that ball. So now it's fourth down, and number 22 is that? Ali Salman? Salman takes it out to 35, puts a foot to it. It's going to go down and hit and take a Fordson roll inside the 20 down to the 15, and that's where Garden City will go on offense. But two quick plays, they gained somewhere in the neighborhood of 27 to 30 yards on the first two, and then Garden City stiffened.
Absolutely, they made some adjustments right there as Fordson came right out right up the middle, and they were causing a lot of grief right up the middle. And
here come the Cougars as they break the huddle. We expect to see number three, Becker, at quarterback. Are we right there as they go straight to the line?
Hey, I can hear you guys bleeding through my speakers here, through my headphones, so you guys can shut your volume down.
Becker is behind, man in motion, and a quick, and Becker gets around. He's got, he keeps it, and he gets 12.
Absolutely, really great play right there. That was designed as a quick hitter, Ted, and then as you see, that was Becker who called his own number. He had a back trailing him. I think that was Brandon Mitchum, or we'll check those numbers down there, that was doing the trailing, but a nice gain of 8 yards on first down.
Edney's the center. He starts the play. Becker, man in motion, is number 11, Spisak, and Becker got hit. Pass is incomplete.
Denzel Tinsley and then Dylan Rayburn were down there deep as there was the pressure put on, and Becker really showed a nice arm, Ted, coming across the field like he did right there. Had a lot of mustard on that ball, but the wide receivers right out of their outstretched hands, and that's going to bring up third down. Third down and one on our scoreboard. This is the opening possession for the Cougars. It's nothing. This is going to be an exciting one. If you're just joining us, don't go anywhere.
Tight veer formation. Tinsley in motion. Becker just goes forward. He fouls the offensive line. Edney at center. White and Patterson at the guards. Briscoe and Covington at the tackles. Just launch forward.
Well, that's exactly what you want right there, Ted, the quarterback. You know, to me, that's a key play for the quarterback when you're down like that, third down and one to go. Call your own number, quick hitter, get your nose up in there and get the first down. Exactly what he did. Nice job by the quarterback, Kyle Becker.
Ball's at the 27-yard line. Hands off. Actually, there's nobody in the backfield. Becker's in the backfield, and they've got a tight formation. Woods carries that one. Picks up, I think we're going to call it four.
DeMartez Woods, 5'8", 151-pounder, right behind Becker, and he's got the handoff again.
And I think he's really close to the first down. It's going to be third down and short. Woods behind Becker. We got Tinsley and Spisak, and both in the wings of this veer formation.
Third down and yard.
And we got a timeout of both teams.
Timeout on the field. Timeout for
we are at the 8:03 mark. No score. Garden City Cougars first possession. They gave up two first downs to Fordson to open the game, and then stiffened a couple penalties, and it looked like for a second that Fordson had scored a touchdown on a pass, but the quarterback had gone over the line of scrimmage. So therefore, that one was called back, and now Garden City is on a march trying to pick up their second first down.
Well, you know, this Tractor team last year, they went a long way. They went deep into the playoffs. They lost that big game against Cass Tech. I was in the attendance on that game. It was, I think, just before the semifinals, and that was the great Mike Weber was on there. And this Fordson team was leading most of the way, and then Mike Weber scored late in the game, and then Fordson got the kickoff, and they ended up with a pass interception at about the 20-yard line. So that's how their season went. They were undefeated last year, 13-0, before the loss to Cass Tech in the quarterfinal action.
A big, huge graduation, and now they're trying to rebuild, but don't worry, Fordson always, always is a strong team. Spisak takes the pitch out, gets the first down, and a little more. He needed one, he got about three, so that'll be the second first down. In this formation, Tinsley, number nine, okay. I got him confused here. I wrote 11 and... I had so much time without you, I needed you to correct my writing.
Replay third down.
That's okay, Ted. We just did quite a bit of baseball here a couple of weeks ago, so we've got to get our football legs underneath of us.
There's the
opening game right here.
Is this going to go against Garden City? Yep. And it's the big 10-yarder holding. No, they're going 15 yards. No, they dropped it at 10. The referee just kept going. So, instead of third and short, it's third and about 11 and a half. So let's see what Coach Murray's got up his sleeve.
This is Rayburn at the bottom of the screen. Keep an eye on him. They've already tried to connect earlier. That's Becker and Rayburn tried to hook up earlier.
Becker cuts inside and runs into a whole host of tractors. I guess there would be a fleet of tractors, right?
Well, absolutely, a fleet of Massey Fergusons and...
Four. We can't be advertising Massey Ferguson. Fordson, you know where that is. It's right down on Ford Road in the heart of Dearborn, a high school founded by Henry Ford. And we are putting formation, ball... inside the 20. Here's the punt. It's going to hit out of bounds. Let's see if they mark it. They mark it on the Fordson side of the 50, so it's about a foot inside of Fordson territory, and that's where the tractors will take over. First and 10 here at the 7:15 mark. We've forgot to tell you that you are watching Omni Edition Sports, over three decades of bringing you Garden City Sports. And Phil Henry, Ted Fournier, privileged to sit up here on the heights of the press box and tell you what's happening. As the quarterback for Fordson, number four, Hamzi Elzerat, is in the pistol formation. Hands off to the man in motion, still deep in the line of scrimmage. Lost the tackle, and he'll fight across the 50. They had him for a 5-yard loss, but he broke free and probably picked up 2 feet.
Well, that was Hakeem coming in motion from the top of the screen out the flanker position, Ted. He had a nice head of steam on him. Great job by the Cougar defense to stretch it all out before he could turn it upfield and get any yards. They reeled him in. It's going to be second and 10.
Kasem Badoin. 5'10", 185 pounders in the backfield. He gets the ball across the 50, cuts inside, dives inside the 45. They're going to mark it right on the 45. Our foot inside picks up 5, so it'll be third down.
Kind of like the Sleeping Bear Sand Dunes. Bay Dune.
Bay Dune.
Kasem Bay Dune. There he goes again.
He's got it again. He breaks tackle. He's skipping. He's elusive. And he hops, skips, jumps across the 40 into the 39 and picks up the first down.
Well, the classic case of what you saw right there, Ted, as they picked up that first down, was they talked about Michigan running back Davion Smith not having field vision. That was perfect vision right there by Badoon, as he really picked his way through and then got the extra yard at the very end to get that first down, Ted. Great vision, found the hole, and then even tried to make more on his own as he got in the middle of the tall timber.
Badoon, I think, is out, and this is a little scat back popped in here.
Jafar, that's Hassan Jafar, number three. Jafar, 5'10", 180 pounds. Shows a little different running style right there over Badoon.
A little quicker feet. Four receivers, two on each side. And boy, is there a lot of whistles here. I mean, I can't tell you how many times they've got ready to play, and all of a sudden the whole Fordson team just sits up and turns around.
Well, that's their strategy right there, Ted. I was going to say they did that against Cass Tech. You know, when they're in sync, they'll get in their formation, and then they all get up and they look over. It's a strategy that they use, if you watch it, Ted, and that's just what they do to try and draw the other team off sides, or I don't know what they're trying to do by that, but you remember some of the teams would come in and then they would kind of, you know, all the linemen would come up and then go down in their three-point stance. Same thing that Fordson tries to do there.
Quick little, it wasn't even a bubble screen, just a toss out to the flanker. Elzerot goes under center. Now he's back in the pistol with a back on both sides. A little screen toss out to the back, and he's got 10 more yards as the ball is now down to the 15.
That was Badoon right there. It was a crossing pattern in the backfield as they were basically at, you know, like a T level right across from one another, Ted. And the ball was faked to Jafar one way. Badoon cut out the other way, and it was a little swing pass, a little bubble screen out to him, and he did it all on his own. And it brings up second down and short, second down and two. They're on the march from the 50-yard line after taking the Garden City punt, Ted.
Out of the I formation under the center, they handoff to number three as he cuts over the left tackle. And once again, Hassan Jafar gets the ball and gets 5 yards.
Well, they're starting to really break up the running attack right now, Ted. They're coming at Garden City from a variety of directions. We saw them come out, primarily take the opening kick, try right up the middle till that wasn't successful. The Garden City defense stiffened this possession right here. They seem to be going inside, outside, but they're favoring that left side right now. So if I'm Coach Murray, I'm looking for making adjustments over on the right side of the defense.
Rolling out, little toss back at the 10 across the 5, and waltzes into the end zone, but they call it a touchdown.
Badoon takes the screen pass right there, hustles out to the right-hand side, and it's 11-yard TD, and they're going to get on the board first.
Well, Garden City has three down linemen facing that massive line, and the linebackers are 4 and 5 yards back off the line of scrimmage, and once they get a good block, it's just, you know, it's a 2 or 3 yard, and then with the elusiveness of their backs, as Saeed, number 14, is kicking. It's
Saeed.
Saeed. I don't know, that was too easy. A big gaping 5 and 10 yard gains as they started the drive at the 49-yard line, a 51-yard drive, and Fordson now leads 7-0, and the defense is gonna have to step it up because there was nothing tricky there, just mostly inside the tackle running, and like I said, Garden City is playing a 3-4 or a 3-5, and they basically are giving up 3 and 4 yards before. Right there is the Cougar Crazies.
Decked out tonight at the big home game. Following the band, Ted, this is a big night for the band here. Garden City's band has kind of fallen on not enough people, you know, to really
well,
come
this
out.
This is the biggest band we've seen in a while. Sahad is going to kick off. Garden City has two P. He, watching him in practice, he can get the ball down there around the 10-yard line. So that's where the deep men are. One are standing inside the five. Left foot kicker. Kicks it along the ground, takes a hop, picked up at the 25, changes direction, crosses the 30, and is planted somewhere along the 32. McGraw's on the kick return.
Yeah,
we'll
that's
give him credit for 7 yards.
Yeah, that's a right along the ground. You want to make it hard to handle, then get your team, get your kick coverage team down there quickly. And McGraw did a nice job. So now they're starting at a really good field position right here, Ted. They're starting at the 32-yard line. They've already had one set of offensive downs in their system. So now it's time to see this offense start clicking as they trail 7-0.
Becker keeps the ball, crosses the 35, gets to the 40. Over the 45-yard line for a first down. Becker on the option out of the beer. We expect to see Kyle carrying it a lot tonight.
That's a nice play right there as Becker really just called his number. He had a back trailing him that he can either fake the pitch to or pitch it back to. But he saw that seam. He got in there along the line of scrimmage. A nice gain, but there's a flag on the field, Ted, and this looks like it's going to go back. Going to bring Garden City back. Spot of the ball, foul.
From the spot of the run.
Well, they ran that play in the first set of downs. Now, that was right at the end of the play, so it's still going to be, is it still first?
First down and 7 from the
36. So they lose the first down, but it's first and 7 now here on this play. Man in motion, pitch out to the man in motion. He cuts inside 40 and gets across to the first down. Is that number 11?
Devin Dodd, number 22.
22 Dodd.
Coming from, the tight formation right there. He wasn't coming from a split in position, Ted. He came right from the slot position right there. Got a nice quick pitch. Found the seam on the left side right there and made nice yardage and a first down.
Running that option, this time a late pitch to Tinsley, and Tinsley gets to the line of scrimmage as Becker took a hit. Just as he hit it, he released the ball. Dangerous play. I remember from years ago, the option plays, the option running teams, those late hits can cause a lot of turnovers. No gain, 2nd and 10, ball on the 44-yard line of the Cougars. They've yet to get into tractor territory. Here is 3:05 left here in the first quarter.
That's Logan McGraw getting in a position at the bottom of the screen. There's that play they've run before,
and
he
keeps
it
again.
Ball is down, and this is going to be a mad scramble in there, as I believe that was Jafar down there that should have picked it up and said he was trying to run with it. So this may be a break to go for the Cougar. It doesn't. Oh.
You know, if you want to tell the story of the Cougar season so far this year, they have had a lot of turnovers. As Becker got hit, he was close, a little short of the first down. He got hit, and the ball went forward, and now the ball will be placed at the 41-yard line of the Tractors, and the Cougars had something going there, but once again, turnovers.
Well, they will be the rue of you right there, Ted, and that was a great run. And right at the end, the ball came flying out of there. Went about 7 yards forward in number four down there, Mohammed Hamka. You know, he had it, and then he tried to run with it before it was secure, and there was a mad scramble, but the Cougars just couldn't get the ball back.
Little quick pass out here to number one. Receiver, he steps out of bounds right across the Asalami, the number one wide receiver, 6 foot tall, 190. Little quick pass, he just turns out, the ball's right there, and he picks up nine. Are they going to give him the first down? 10 yards on that play.
Inside of Cougar territory now.
Same play, and he's thrown out of bounds. Al-Salami twice in a row. Just two little out patterns. He takes a couple steps, 4 yards, turns out. Quick 1-2-3, and the ball's there. Picks up a little 3.5-4 yards, second and seven.
Baydoun is not in the game. Kassam Baydoun is not in. He has the touchdown. There's a nice little cut back right there, and this is going to be trouble. Nice.
Number
tackle.
Two, Hassan Hassim? Hassam on the carry. Number two, he's a little quick scat back. So they've had three backs in there so far today.
Hunter Damon made a nice touchdown-saving tackle right there for the Cougars. Got him around the waist, didn't let go, and spun him down. But once again, big yardage. They're picking up the flag.
For our three receivers to the top, one to this side, Hassim to back. Big gaps in between the offensive line there.
See, and that's deliberate right there. They do that, and it's designed to kind of draw the other team off guard or off sides, Ted. That's all you can say, but it's a consistent move that
Hassim
they do.
Hassim cuts inside, headed toward the right side of the line, cut back behind the center, and gets it inside the 30. Awesome. I tell you, you know, if you brought a kid here to watch football and then asked him what a huddle was at the end of the game, he had no idea, because neither team are huddling.
Baydoun's back in the game right now. That's him going along the line of scrimmage, resets himself. Now they go into that T formation.
Hand off to the back. Is that Jafar? Three is still in there. They had wholesale changes. Jafar gets close to the 25, so it's going to be short of the first down by three.
Well, right now the Tractors are really showing a variety of weapons on the offensive side of the ball. Everything's starting right through the quarterback, Hazim Al-Ziyat. And then he's got the wide receiver down there at the bottom of the screen is Al-Salami. Then, of course, Kassam Baydoun. And then Jafar. There's been a lot of weapons used right now by the Tractors.
Hand off, spinning move across the 25. Short of the first down, it's going to be fourth down. Jafar gets close, but he's about a yard and a half short. And it'll be fourth down, but this is fourth down territory. Ball inside the 25. They got to get down to the 23.
Yeah,
we'll
nice,
call it two.
Nice move in there by Logan McGraw and company. We saw Logan McGraw, number six, coming in from the free safety position and finishing off that tackle. Great opportunity right now for the Cougar defense to stiffen, Ted. This is a big play right here. Third down and fourth down and two.
Hands off to Baydoun. Baydoun's got first down and more. Cuts to the outside. 10, 5, into the end zone. Touchdown. Kason Baydoun cut over the left tackle after he beat the outside containment. There was nobody home to bring him down. And Fordson at the 2-second mark of the first quarter scores, and it's now 13-0.
DeMartez Woods, number one, was trying to give chase right there, Ted, but it was just too much angle to cover. And Baydoun, once he got to the outside, really had another burst of speed and just saw that corner pylon, and nobody was going to beat him there, as we see right there. And that's actually number seven. It looked like a one to me. I thought it was DeMartez Woods, but it's actually Hunter Damon. Called his name several times, and they're going to, there's a flag on the play. Broken try for the extra point. It's going to end up in two, but we've got a flag there, and we've got motion. Motion going to be called on Fordson.
Illegal shift on the offense.
They have an illegal shift.
Replay the try.
And they're going to bring that ball back five. And let's see if they go for two. I didn't know if that was a design play or a broken play as the holder got up and went to his left and threw a pass into the end zone to Lopez, but they're gonna set up for a one-pointer again as Sahad is going to, the ball is placed down.
Plenty of leg. This is,
and
he
it's
nailed
good.
It.
So it's 14-0, Phil. And I was going to say after that last that touchdown play, Phil, because Garden City had 11 guys in the box. They had 11 guys within 3 yards or 4 yards of the line of scrimmage. And it was going to be, once you broke that along the end, there was no safety pursuit or corner containment. And that was a pretty easy touchdown.
Well, it was a misdirection play, Ted. You know, they lined up in a power formation, and then they sent the Baydoun off to the crossing pattern and went off tackle to the left side, coming from the right side. And once he got past the initial line of scrimmage, Ted, exactly to your point, 11 men in the box, there was nobody home. Great job to try to chase him down by Hunter Damon. We called his number a couple of times tonight and just didn't have the angle or the extra burst of speed that he needed. And here's the Fordson Tractors coming in here, flexing their muscle in the first quarter. It's 14-0, Ted.
Tinsley and Castone is are back deep. They're standing at the 5-yard line. Last time, Saad just dribbled it right through the middle of the Cougar formation. Let's see what they do this time. Left footer. This is a high one. It's going to be taken right at the 10, 15, 20. Breaks outside, 25, 30, 35, and knocked out of bounds around the 39-yard line. And that's the end of the first quarter.
Castonde.
And we're going to switch sides, Phil, here. And like you said, Fordson has come out here, and after being almost stopping themselves on with penalties on that first drive, it's been all business on the second and third drive.
Well, they showed a variety of offensive weapons and then different formations, and really caught the Cougars just not being able to be in the right spot at the right time. They just methodically moved down. They went to the out route passing on the first plays, and then after that they started showing their running muscle, and they just did a really nice drive. But they got the ball at the 50-yard line, Ted, so you didn't have far to go. And so the Cougars did a great job by making them use almost all their plays, but at the end of the day, they got into the end zone. It's 14-0. And how about this? Incorporate graphics. You know, our buddies right there across the street. Look at that. They just do it all, don't they? I mean, you know, they make everything up over there, Ted. You know.
Well, you got the Panthers and the Tigers, and we have to favor the Tigers today because Dan York is a Tiger, and my wife's a Tiger. Becker, late pitch, way back to the 30, trap 35, 40, and he gains a couple, but that was a late pitch by Kyle Becker, the quarterback, and Tinsley made lemonade out of lemon there.
Well, you know, too, if you kind of looked at it, he kind of showed a little bit like he might pass that ball, Ted, and I think that was just enough to freeze the defenders for that split second that he needed to be able to turn it upfield and actually, you know, take a maybe a 4 or 5 yard loss and turn it into a 1 yard gain. Nice job by Tinsley right there, just that little fake, and sometimes you freeze somebody and take advantage of it. Cougars just need to have a good old-fashioned drive right now, Ted. You know,
Isaac in motion. Pitch out to him. He trails it down, but he's rudely met for a loss of about 4 at the 36-yard line as the Cougars have just been running sweep left and sweep right. And did they get him for a face mask? Because the flag is at right where he was hit.
Yeah, they're putting at the spot right there. That was Monier Lopez who cut and beat the blocker right down there at that end and got around the blocker, and it was a nice pitch. Really caught number 11 there, Spizak, right in stride, Ted.
Dead ball foul, personal foul on number 11. That is a dead ball foul. We will assess 15-yard penalty against Garden City.
So that looks like it's going to go against Spizak himself right there as he was brought down.
I don't know if we can get it. Did he put a hand to the face mask, or I don't know what he did there. I mean, he got hit. It could have been a hand to the face. Well, that's So he loses three, and then he loses 15 more, which doesn't add up. That's a they added 10 on that one.
Well, this is a big boys game down there, and I'm sure there was some roughing going on in that tackle, and Spezak probably you know, took exception to it, Ted, and sort of got back. Unfortunately, the officials were right on top of it, and it cost them 15.
Well, that flagrant right where they made contact, so that's why I thought it might have been a stiff arm to the face, but we can't see that, so. Anyway, Garden City's ready to go. Receiver to the near side. Man in motion, back to pass, Becker in trouble, evades one. Now he's coming across the 30, 35, and he's out of bounds. And that'll be fourth down. And
you see number 55 down there for the Tractors, Ali Joma. You know, Joma is 6'1", 290. And he takes up a lot of space there in the middle of the line, but that was a time right there where Becker was able to just use his speed and get past him, you know, to get it up, you know, close to the original line of scrimmage, Ted. But that 15-yard penalty was just absolutely killer. Too much for the Cougars to overcome in this possession as they're going to punt it away.
Punter standing out to 20. Gets the ball off. The ball's taken, coming across midfield.
That's Hachim.
And that's the Tractors once again going to be in Cougar territory. And the Cougars have yet to cross the 50-yard line. Hachim is going to be at the 49-yard line. I guess there are huddles, but they're on the sidelines now. 11:24, second quarter. Garden City trailing 14-0. Dearborn, Fordson, Tractors in the white and gold pants. Cougars in the dark blue, black pants, and not bright enough orange numbers. Back out of the shotgun, the handoff, big gaping hole, has 9 yards.
Once again, another terrific job right there of having vision for a running back, Ted. Yeah, that play was designed to go outside, and Jafar took the handoff and took one look on the inside, found that seam, and took it for 8 yards.
Jafar by himself takes it again, finds a hole on the right side, gets the first down, falls down across the 36-yard line. Tractors immediately get into formation, and as you have explained, they will get in the set. They'd all sit up and take a look at the there you go. I thought they were going to make liars out of me. Now they're getting to play. Tafar is in the backfield with the quarterback, Elza Yacht, and Tafar got the ball, cuts. He came east and west that time and then decided to head towards Warren Avenue, and he didn't pick up anything there.
Brandon Grace stayed home at that time right there, Ted, and did a nice job, you know, not letting Jafar get outside, and wrapped him up, and a host of a couple of others helped and brought him right down. That's a big play right now, forces second down in 11.
Jafar. 5'10", 180 pounds in the backfield. Back to pass. Throwing down, right down the center. And he caught that. Was that number two? Between two defenders? Beautiful pass right down the center of the formation. And Fordson scores their third touchdown, is now 20-0.
Hachim did what a catch he made. You know, he broke open, and Alziat, you know, saw that, just that little bit of the window right there, right between the two defenders, and laid that ball right in stride. And Hassan
had one-on-one coverage, Hachim, on both wide receivers, but the one he threw to was double covered. And here we're going to go the point after, and we have a timeout or encroachment. What do we got here? We have just had one whistle after another.
Dead ball foul. False start on number 66 offense. We'll replay the try.
Well, this is exactly the same thing that happened last time. We have some movement along the line, and Dearborn Fordson is going to be kicking out, kicking this extra point from the 15, making it a 25-yard extra point. Ball is down, and it is good. So it's 21-0 at the 9:44 mark. And Garden City has right here has got to have a drive. They can't afford to give Dearborn these 40-yard. There's a one-handed. He shaked that thing one-handed as it was. It looked like it was overthrown, and he brought that one in. And what a great catch you see here in high school. And like I said, both outside receivers in single coverage. I was wondering when they were going to pass because Garden City keeps creeping up their safeties and their corners, and many times they've got 10 or 11 in the box, and that makes a passing game look very tempting to Dearborn.
Well, and that was just a perfect pass right there. He put it right between those two defenders. I don't think he could have found a better spot. The receiver was in stride. He reached up with the one hand and reeled it right in and just had a couple of strides into the end zone. So that was, sometimes we have a catch and run. That time that was a run. Excuse me, that was a catch and a little bit of run. And just a terrific play as the Tractors go up 21-0. And, you know, Garden City, the last time they took the kickoff, you know, Essengay really got them off to a great return. And then, you know, things, the wheels came off. That big 15-yard penalty really hurt. So now there's 21-0, and let's see if they can get it going here, Ted.
Sade kicks off. The ball's taken back on the 10. And Essengay takes it over towards the 25, 15-yard return. And this will be, I think, the worst starting position for the Cougars.
Well, and right now Fordson kind of has them right where they want them because the Cougars, you know, really need to get back into this game. So the tendency may be to go to the air. But, you know, to me, it's still plenty of football left in this. We're in the first half right here, Ted. Just get a nice, good old-fashioned drive going right now and then take some time off the clock, get in there, get into the end zone, and start feeling good about yourselves. This one's handed off, but he's going to be stacked up. As you can see right there, that's number one.
Woods.
Demartrez Woods.
Demartrez Woods. You know, in this offense, you need some positive yards out of your tailback, out of your deep back. If Woods can't get across the line of scrimmage, then they ignore him every time and just track whoever's in motion. But that's option one on this offense. And if they can't get any positive yards out of him, it kind of makes the rest of the offense negligible. Same handoff, pick up of maybe two. Woods to the left, Woods to the right, that time to the left, and he picked up maybe one or two, so it's going to be, let's make it long six, short seven. Third down, and this is a big play right here. You do not want to give up the ball right away.
Well, and the other thing I'm noticing is the bunch formation by the offense, you know, and then that bunches in the bigger Fordson players. It's not really given any running room, as we see right there. The running back, you know, got up and got up to the 31.
Well,
and, not close enough for a first down, though, Ted.
They're running the old Lions offense right here. Tailback to the left, tailback to the right, tailback to the left, punter kick.
And they're going for it, fourth and six.
Fourth and six on the 30-yard line.
Fourth and three now is corrected on the scoreboard. Fourth and three, Ted.
There's another penalty. So it might be fourth down and eight now.
Dead ball foul. Ball start on the offense. Number two, 5-yard penalty.
Number two.
Well,
so
I would
Rayburn
assume.
Split wide left, and he just
Dylan Rayburn
was probably way out of the play too, Ted, and that's going to move him back now to bring up.
Well, you can't fumble, and you can't have this many penalties, and expect to be successful. We're going to punt again, and the Fordson should have good field position once again. Kicked it from the 15, take it at the 45, across the 50, across the 45, 40, still on his feet inside the 40, and Fordson will take over around the 37-yard line with 7:36 left and leading 21-0.
That was Hakeem right there on that punt return, Ted, and he literally walked about 10 yards on that one before there was any return coverage on him. Waltzed over into Garden City territory. They're going to be starting at perfect field position right about the 38-yard line.
Hakeem, all-around athlete. We've seen him make that catch and taking the ball and kicking off, taking out the punts. Let's see if we got the same players in here. Jafar, number 3, should be in the backfield. Still the first team in there. Number 4, Hamzi Elziat, the quarterback, looking for the play. Jafar in the backfield with him. Now another whistle.
But if you notice the difference, between the two teams right here. Right now, Fordson has a spread offense going at this point, Ted, where they've utilized the spread offense, and then that spreads out the defense, and then that's creating those running lanes that they've chosen to use them.
Basically, you see two different philosophies. Fordson's running the modern, I call it arena football offense, and the Cougars are running the old veer. Little bubble screen cuts inside, across the formation, has one man to get around. He's still coming back. He's across the 40, 35, still on his feet. There's a rugby scrum around the 32-yard line, but a lot of action. Hashim took that ball on a bubble screen, cut inside, went all the way across the field on the formation, decided there was no openings there, turned around, came back, and then got gang tackled.
Well, that was a terrific play right there by Hashim. I think he actually ran the enough distance to get a touchdown out of that, but he was in the middle of the field.
Ball's picked up by the quarterback after a fumbled snap. He goes around the right tackle. He's down, picks up some positive yardage, gets around the 30-yard line. He'll be a couple yards short.
That was Michael Trimble and Brandon Grace, a couple of the captains on the team down there, stiffening up on that left side of the defense for the Cougars. That was a broken play. That can be big trouble a lot of times, Ted, you know, and especially when they're spread offense like that. And Elziat was on his horse, and great job by Trimble and...
Elziat keeps the ball, gets across the 25-20, 15, stumbles down inside the 10. It's going to be first down and goal. We got to always look for the laundry.
Nick Edney doing a great job of reeling in Elziat. The holding play was going to bring it back anyway, but nonetheless, he was heading for the end zone right there. Nice.
Well, that was a design play. He faked the handoff. The motion of the offense, all the lines going right, and he cuts behind the line, and he picked up good yardage, but he got a little help from a hold. And I guess you could probably call a hold. I know when I played, you could call a hold on every play, but.
Got to be something pretty flagrant nowadays, right in front of an official or turn somebody around. That was going one way.
Yeah, you should never compliment the guy you're blocking about his new tattoo.
So we see the spread offense right here for Fordson right now. And what it does, Ted, is it gives them plenty of room to wheel and deal on the offensive side of things. We're seeing when the Cougars have the ball, they're bunched up and they're not getting the breathing room.
It's the offenses of the future. It's arena football come to the big field. And here's a handoff and gang tackled at the 30. Another play.
I think these guys were flown in last night from the Bronco Chiefs game. The ball game had a lot of penalties in it. I think this is the same
officiating crew. Illegal formation or shift again. I don't know.
calling it tight tonight is this crew. Always doing a great job, and there's the cheerleaders. You notice the black coming in this year. The boys of fall football, I like that. That's a great, great slogan for the year. We want to see them get down and do some push-ups, though, the traditional push-ups that the cheerleaders do after a score by the Cougars, so the Cougars need to get the ball back and get it into the end zone, Ted. We're here 5 minutes and 40 seconds to go in the first half, and they're trailing 21 to nothing. They need a turnover and kind of run it on in from there.
Fordson, first and 15, handoff to Jafar. He picks up at least five here down to the 25-yard line. I think we've crossed the 25-yard line two or three times in this series.
Brandon Grace once again getting up from the bottom of the pile. Right.
Hand off again right up the middle behind the center down to the 20-yard line. Should be third and five. This huge offensive line for Fordson is owning the line of scrimmage. It's actually 5-3 on the line of scrimmage. Cougars have three down linemen. Some huge gaps and two quick blocks, and there's hole every time. Nobody in the backfield, five receivers as everybody split. Two to the top, three to the near side. It looks like two good blocks and a quarterback draw would get him the first down. Man in motion. Hands it off, gets around the end, cuts inside the 10. El Hajj, the fifth player to carry the ball tonight for Fordson. And now it's first and goal. So they had first and 15, and three plays in a row, they gained 5, 5, and 15, and that'll add up to a first down every time.
Well, that's that counter play right there, Ted, and that's what I'm talking about. When the field is spread like that, it doesn't take much of a seam to get past that line of scrimmage. And that time, like you said, that was Elijah coming in from the bottom flanker position and then caught it off right tackle and made nice gainer there on third and four.
Jafar inside the 10, cuts back, tries to dive to the 5. He'll probably fell on the 6-yard line. As they ran out of the I formation that time. They've had multiple formations. They've had five receivers, empty backfield. They've had two backs next to a pistol formation. They've been under center. They've run a pro set. They've run an I formation. Right now they're in a little pro set. Backs split slightly behind the quarterback. Turn around the pitch, coming to the left side. Gets inside the 5 and falls forward down toward the 3. Jafar.
Yeah, there you
they
go.
They just look like a well-disciplined offensive unit here, Bill.
Well, this team is 1-2 coming in here, and you know, I saw them play it when they were 13-0 last year against Cass Tech, and they held Cass Tech and gave them a heck of a football game. So there's a lot of experience, I'm sure, that came back. You said they had heavy graduations as Coach Murray goes out and signals for a timeout. You know, he's got his hands at his hips, and you know, he wants to.
Well, you can't argue about their first game. They went out and played Canton. Canton's perennial power, one of the top 10 in the year in and year out. It seems like with three high schools on the corner, it seems like almost all the good football players go to the same high school. I don't want to say that. Of course, they do have a lotto there. And I don't know if they freeze the envelopes or tape them to the bottom of the bin. But it seems like Salem and Plymouth do not get their fair share of the great football players.
Well, they got Tim Batchelor over there. He's just been a heck of a coach, and he has a program. He runs it a certain way, and he runs the veer. And it's really hard to defend at this level right here. Everything's timing. Everybody's got to be in the right spot. And lots of trickery and chicanery going on with the quarterback. And that really creates a real nice atmosphere to beat the other team down and eventually pull away.
The sad part is Canton's not even the best team in their league. Celine is a powerhouse this year out there. Quarterback, split backfield, hands off to the tailback, Jabbar, and he gets close.
Big number 52, Nick Edney, getting up from the bottom of that pile down there. This is going to be fourth and one. The ball's at the 3 yard line, Ted. They're just going to go for it.
I'm telling you, if I'm the quarterback, I just go forward and no, I think he got stopped. He went up and over. No, what did they say? Did he get over? The referee said yes. But Jafar went up and over. But if you look at the way when they line up, it looked like if Elziot just fouled his center, there was nobody who was going to stop him. But Jafar goes in and makes it 27 to nothing here at the 218 mark.
Well, it's a great play in there, Brandon Grace. One more time here, we're going to take a look at it, and you know, we don't have a camera down the line right there, so, but he didn't have much to go if you see where the goal line is right there, Ted. Great job by the Garden City defenders, you know, to go and bring him slamming to the ground. That tells me they're still playing. Here's a couple of the boys coming off. Number 73 coming off there, Sean Moore. Number 7, we've called him tonight. He's done a great job, Hunter Damon. There it is, that play right there. Look at that, Brandon Grace, number 52. Knocked him right back. There's 88 in there, Mason Jennings standing people up. But once again, the ball breaks the plane, Ted, as you can see from the replay right there, and that's all it took, and it's 28 to nothing in the 1 yard run by Jafar. And that's the fourth or third different player to score. Baydoun has two of them. We haven't seen Baydoun. He's sort of retired for the night. He caught an 11-yard touchdown pass and a 25-yard run for the first two scores. And then he's been kind of silent after that.
Well, it's like, you know, Fordson, we said it's a fleet of trackers. They have a fleet of running backs here. We've seen Hashim, we've seen Jafar, we've seen Baydoun. All three of them have been effective. And Sahadi, number 14, kicking off. His toe is going to have to be put in the ice bucket. He's done a lot of kicking today. This is his fifth kickoff, and he's kicked four extra points. And
well, there's still 2:18 to go. It's still time to get on the board for the Cougars right now. Castengay has been back there today. Let's see if he's the one with the ball. He sure is, and this time he couldn't find any running room. He's been successful bringing back the kicks, Ted, but not that one, as they're nailed right just short of the 20-yard line, so they've got their work cut out for them. You're Ron Murray. What do you do?
Well, I go out here and show out something different. I don't know what he has in his playbook, but this offense, Fordson knows how to defend it. Fordson has figured out they've stopped the deep back, and anytime they pitch out, they've hit Becker, and they've for the most part contained the deep back. And the other thing is, when they have got yardage, the plays have been called back because of holding. So here's that veer again. He reversed this field.
Tinsley tried to find some running room there, Ted. You know, you like the effort right there. When the play was designed to go to his right, he didn't see anything he liked, reversed his field right there. But once again, the bunched up offense just isn't creating the big bodies of Fordson right now are just not really, you know, getting separated enough to create a running lane.
You can run that veer, you can run this bunch up, but you gotta have speed to get to the outside, and you gotta have a big bruising back that's gonna get you 3 or 4 yards in between the tackles. And so far, the Cougars haven't shown the speed to get to the outside, nor have they shown the big bruising back to get through the middle. So, I mean, I don't know what the rest of the offense looks like. Maybe they're holding something back for the second half, but here they have been extremely conservative. The last time they ran, they literally ran their fullback three times in between the tackles, and they gained eight yards and then had a penalty. So.
Well, you look at the, you know, they have a wide side of the field down here with the, you got the thing is DeMart, that's Woods out there, and there's going to be a.
And here you have the outside linebacker coming in, not even worrying about the pitch and tackling Becker. And the other thing now, Phil, watch the next play. Other than the wide receiver that's out, Fordson has 10 people in the box. I mean, it is going to be extremely hard to run against that defense.
Well, you got Hunter Dameon down here at the wide side of the field. There's a large gap between the offensive lineman and Dameon that looks like just a perfect spot to sneak Tinsley in there. You know, it looks like he has the speed. Instead, he's trying to cut his break up too soon at the line of scrimmage. Needs to stretch it out a little bit and just start spreading this field out a little bit. The tractors, you know.
And the other thing that's happening, the wing backs that set up outside the offensive line and go in motion are going deep. You know, when they cut across the formation, they're 6-7 yards deep behind the quarterback, and when they get the ball at the pitch, they're 6-7 yards behind the line of scrimmage, and the speed of the backers for the Fordson Tractors are meeting him in the backfield.
Yeah, and I called him Ron Murray. I meant Scott Murray, of course. You know that the head coach.
Now they've brought somebody deeper, but they've got eight in the box now. Here's watch. Here's a pass. Incomplete.
That was a out there to Cameron Walker. Excuse me, that's Walter Cameron
now,
Walter, number 81.
It's fourth down. They're deep in their territory. Number two. Hassim's going to go out to 45-yard line, going to take the punt, and with 2 minutes to go here, a little under 2 minutes, Fortson's going to probably have the ball at least inside the 50-yard line, unless he just lets the ball go here.
Well, this is the classic case sometimes about kicking your coverage. And this one is not going to outkick the coverage, although it takes a big bounce. And there's Hashim right there, and he's already in Cougar
40,
territory.
35-30. Still on his feet. Another flag is thrown. There's another flag thrown. And the ball right now is near the 20-yard line, but we have two flags thrown. This has not been a well-disciplined team. There are at least three plays on the field here, Phil.
And no indication of which direction it's going right now.
We could have.
There are multiple fouls.
So let's see if we can pick up something here. There's Hashim right there, and he's just gliding at that point. Edney, there's the flag coming in there. It could have been the penalty on number 33, Michael Trimble.
Well,
flying, then there's one at the tail end.
Fordson had 11 players on the field, and three of them got called for penalties. We had two blocks in the back, and we had a holding.
Yeah, when you
so
saw
the ball is going to be
like
at the 38-yard line, 39-yard line. Actually, the penalty was at the 48, and they gave him a 9-yard penalty.
Nice wide shot right there for your enjoyment tonight, Garden City football. Can't see the scoreboard that well, so we won't see that 28-0.
Let's see the philosophy here with 141. If Fortune's just going to run it, or they're going to go for a quick score here. And they go into formation. They stand up. Hey, we have the reappearance of Baydoun. Baydoun's back in the backfield, number 24. He's about a step and a half away from the quarterback. Back to pass. And
picked
it's
off.
Picked off by Garden City. And he's going to be tackled. The interception at the 47. And McGraw gets tackled at the 41. And with 1:31 left, let's see if Garden City can turn the momentum around here.
Excellent right there in the right place at the right time was McGraw, as that ball was a rifle shot in there by Al Sahim, and that came right off of the receiver right there. Bounced right up, right into the hands of McGraw. And of course, he knows what to do with it right there. Now he kind of draws up a little bit and run right into the tackler.
Back to pass is Becker. Becker has a receiver, picked off by Fordson. He's got some blockers. He cuts to the outside. He's at the 50, 45, 40, 35. He's on his horse, one man to beat, and he will score. Touchdown, a interception, and a 75-yard touchdown return. Penalty marker on the block in the back.
We've called him Hakeem. We've called him Hashem. So we'll call him anything he wants to after that. What a terrific play right there. Now, that was a play that looked to me like just got away from Becker. He had two receivers in the area, Ted, and he threw the ball right between both of his receivers right into Hashim's hands. And we're going to have a penalty to sort out.
Penalty is on the 25-yard line. What did he say? There's a penalty at the middle of the field on the 25-yard line, which was 40 yards away from the play.
Well, here it is right here. He's coming at us, and Hakeem does a fabulous job of waiting for his blockers, Ted. I mean, you know, this is the running back inning. We've already seen him in the end zone once tonight. He's got a convoy. The penalty's going to take place right in here, and it's got to be.
That was questionable, that one.
If that's what they called it, because that was where the Markov was from that area. I don't know, unless it was outside of our camera. Great camera work in there, really tight. Saw the convoy of blockers, just exactly what you would see if you were a Cougar on the defensive side of things.
So back-to-back interceptions. There's a little pass inside the 30, down inside the 25.
Mohammed Sarini.
On the reception as we are at the 103 mark. First and 10. Fordson back to pass again. He's into a little trouble, kind of run outside. He has a receiver in the end zone. Two. And there are no flags on the field. Touchdown. There was a one-on-one coverage in the end zone. A nice job eluding the, he had a lot of time, and Elzerat just threw the ball to the outside shoulder and caught him, and it is now 34 to nothing.
Elzerat was a fabulous play right there. He had tremendous field vision, Ted. He rolled to his right, watched the receiver, Hashim, as he broke open. And this guy really has a really great sense for the quarterback. He knows right when to throw the ball. And once again, threw it right in there. And he connected with Hashim earlier tonight on a 37-yard one. This one's a 23-yard. And they're going to go up now 34 to nothing, and there's your flag, Ted. You know, I thought you were getting
lonesome
for a flag.
Well, that's the third time on the extra point that Fordson has had movement. And the referees are going to go in at halftime and wash the penalty flags. So no good, it's 34 to nothing. And we are in the last minute of play here.
Well, right now their offense, just the Cougars are befuddled, to say the least, of how to stop the Tractors right now. They've got the Tractor in low gear and they're just running right over top of the Cougars. So there's gonna have to be some adjustments made. Scott Murray's gonna have to make some adjustments in there at halftime, Ted. It's gonna be so important because, you know, we've seen that the Cougars are still playing football. They have not given up on this game. They can't look at the scoreboard. They've given up 34 points here in the first half. There's still a whole half of football. We see how things funny bounces. We just saw an interception, back-to-back interceptions. And the Cougars, you know, just have to get out there, get the opening kick, and start feeling good about themselves. You know, Caston Gay is back there deep, along, I believe, with Tinsley. Cougars have been getting some good kick returns and a lot of practice. That it was, it's the seventh kick.
He kicks it, Caston Gay gets the ball, and it goes out of bounds, or?
Well, that ball right there had a little backward English on it,
Castonia,
Ted.
Castonia got the ball at the 15.
That almost, you know, that's a live ball down there.
And well, you got to fall on it. You can't just let it.
I think that was Castonia that was going to go after it, and then the ball bounced straight up in the air, and he was waiting for it to come back to him. Well, in the meantime, the kick coverage was right on top of him. So right now, back at work behind or underneath the center is going to be Kyle Becker.
Woods with the carry. Now we're going to have a late unsportsmanlike conduct as the Fordson man hit the man in motion probably 10 yards behind the line of scrimmage for no reason.
Becker. It was Becker after the handoff right there. Yeah, Becker went running back, and I don't know what that was
all
about.
See if we can see that again, the truck there, because, well, it's not necessary, but Becker was way out of the play and he got hit.
Yeah, he wasn't even in the camera shot right there. You just saw that sometimes there's those little vendettas there, Ted, or little paybacks or some game within the game, if you will. And it cost the Tractors 15, and there's another flag flying in there.
Why don't we just say the ball's height is a flag on the play, and Woods carries it. That's twice in a row. I think Scott Murray would like to just run the clock out and get in there.
Personal foul on the defense, illegal contact to the face, 15-yard penalty.
Which number was?
The result of the first down.
Which number? Seven.
Personal fouls here, that's back-to-back personal fouls.
Yeah, and you're up 34-0. I don't know why you need to be chippy at this point. I think you could just point to the scoreboard, Ted. You don't need to be drawn into anything where you're, you know, going after players and paying back. And, you know, we don't know what's going on down there in the field of battle between these two teams. They're both 1-2 right here, and Fortson's going a long way to trying to be 2-2 on the season. But back-to-back personal foul penalties when you're up 34-0, I gotta believe that the coach isn't gonna be too happy about
this
that.
This is the first time Garden City's been in Fordson territory, and Woods gets inside the 45 down to the 43.
Great tough running in there by Woods, you know, as he lowered his shoulder down, knocked the Tractor right out of the way, and then steamrolled ahead for a couple of yards.
Garden City finally got into Fordson territory here with the help of 30 yards of penalties. And that was a 5-yard play for Woods. And so they take time out here with second down. Only 26.7 seconds left on the clock.
All right. Cheerleaders are getting ready. They want to do some push-ups, Ted. You know, I mean, it's traditional.
Garden City needs a score here.
They absolutely do. And this really important part of this football game right here, you know, just before halftime, you're trailing 34-0. There's a lot of football left. You know, you've got to really take it to the Tractors right now and get into the end zone.
A little quick pass, a high and through the hands to the intended receiver.
Hunter Damon down there. Might have heard some footsteps. The ball still delivered a little bit high by Becker.
Murray talking to Dylan Rayburn, number two. I was looking at the coaching staff for Dearborn, Fordson. They've got 14 coaches. 14.
Well, I think if your kid is on the team, you're a coach. They got a guy named Rocco Horvath.
Catch and cut, complete at the 36-yard line. Rayburn with the catch.
Nice job right there to get the first down and get out of bounds to stop the clock. You know, really great
19
job.
Seconds left, 19.9, so almost 20. Let's see if they have something that can take some shots at the end zone here. Takes a deep one, deep, but way out of bounds. Probably about, do we have another one of those yellow things?
Personal foul, roughing the passer.
Well, once again, now that's 45 yards and personal foul penalties on this drive against Fordson. And that looked like number 55 down there, the big man, Ali Zoma. Or Joma. 6'1", 290 pounds. You know, I wouldn't want to get him riled up too much right down there, Ted. You know, that's
so Garden City has gone 45 yards down the field, and they actually offensively have gained five. The rest has been the rest has been penalties. Back again, little sidearm through the hands of the receiver at the 15-yard line. And this clock is going down one tick at a time. 11.9. Second down and 10.
All on the 21-yard line, Ted. It's once again, there's, you know, 11 seconds to go. Real important part of the game for the Cougars.
Back to pass, Becker, a little caught behind him. He cuts inside. He's got open space, and he's tackled at the 10-yard line, or the, I think he's inside at around the 5, but 3.4 seconds to go. It'll be first and goal.
Cougars have one timeout remaining right now,
and
they're
going
to have to use it.
Now, literally, Phil, and I don't remember all the penalties, but Garden City took this ball.
Timeout on the field, Garden City. That is
right.
The last timeout this
And had. They got all the way down to the 20 with 1 5-yard gain. The rest was penalties because some of those penalties were more than 15 yards from where they took place.
Right here, you see Woods as he looks. Yeah. Comes right over the end right there and, you know, brought down right at the very end. Terrific vision by Woods as he cut that one back to the middle of the field. And, you know, he had a lot of speed, but all of a sudden the tractors were closing in on him and he had no help down there. Nice, terrific job hanging onto the football, getting down. They're inside, ball
on
spotted
the
six-yard line, Ted.
3.4 seconds to go. So let's see if they can get more than one play here. It's got to be a quick hitter or
no timeouts left for either team.
Becker in the rear. He's under center. The rush is on and he is buried back at the 15. Is there offsides? That was really close, and that'll be the end of the quarter as Fortune brought everybody in the house in there on him right up the middle. And the score at halftime here on Omni Additional Sports, Dearborn, Courts and Tractors 34, your Garden City Cougars, nothing.
We'll be right back with second half action, and it promises to be a good one.
Where we recreate the hottest looks from today's biggest music videos.
After cleaning out our closet, we have a lot of clothes we don't wear anymore.
Like this old pile of t-shirts.
It's not garbage, it's actually a new rug.
And to make it, all you need to do is cut, tie, and glue.
Cut the t-shirt into strips.
Tie the strips into knots.
And glue the knots to the bath mat. I love it. Give your garbage another life.
And recycle.
Welcome back to Garden City High School, where today Dearborn Fordson, the tractors from Dearborn Fordson, are coming in here invading Cougar land. Garden City Cougars are trailing 34-0 here as we're about ready to start the third quarter. I'm Ted Fournier. I'm along with my longtime broadcast partner, Phil Henry, and he's ready to go here for the second half. And Phil, I know you have some words of wisdom.
It's Friday Night Lights. We just got a rousing rendition by the Pom Pom Girls. I mean, that's just always makes the event when they come out here. That is a world class. You know, for $5, that's worth the price of admission alone during halftime to see them out there doing their show. And this is, you know, Friday night football. I mean, it's sacred. You know, it's high school football. This is, it just doesn't get any better than this. And we hope the football gets a little bit better. There was a lot of penalties in that first half, kind of wrapping everything up in that first half, Ted. And the Tractors really put on an offensive show right there. They ran left, they ran right, they passed the ball. They showed a lot of variety in weapons, and the Cougars were just kind of befuddled at times. And the second half promises to be a lot better.
I was going to bring up one of my $8 words. There were a plethora of penalties.
I think every penalty was called in the first half. Some signals I've never seen before. But Cougars are going to receive right here. And they've been on the receiving end several kickoffs here in this game.
Ball is dropped on the 15. Going to go wide to the right, trying to get around the corner. Got to around the 20. 25, still on his feet, looking for a block, and finally gets planted around the 26 or 27 yard line, and that was number 10, Elon Costengay.
Costengay.
I don't know.
I'm just telling you, Ted, we might as well get it out there, you know, give out your home address so everybody knows where to come and tell you about their kid's name. But yeah, we really feel bad about that, as he's a little slow getting up. Costengay, you know, has really been a bright spot for the Cougars in kickoff returns, and he's sitting down right now, and here comes the staff, and she's got a big smile on her face, and you like to see that, meaning that nothing's serious. There's Coach Murray out there, and he wants to have a few words, and one of the officials.
Well, Garden City's going to start at their own 26-yard line here. They are trailing 34-0, five touchdowns. One miss. We're going to watch him on this play here. And you can see at the end there where they tried to help him out. He probably got his bell rung.
Well, flat down like that, Ted, a lot of times, you know, he could have fallen on the ball, just like lost his wind, you know, got the wind knocked out of him. And, you know, that's pretty debilitating. Debilitating, I guess, would be the 8-point word. And he's up and at him, and the Cougars are going to take over first and 10, but way back.
Kyle Becker's been the quarterback all night long, running out of the veer. He's got back on each wing. One Woods, DeMartez Woods is behind him, and one receiver. And hands off to Woods going up the middle, nothing doing. That play has not got a lot of yards, had a 1 5-yard gain here in the first half. Woods, that's option one in this offense, and they, you gotta keep them honest.
Now that was Chase Patterson, some of the big guys down there. We're gonna try and get a lot of those names in as the second half unfolds right here. They've really had their work cut out for them against these big tractors. They come in here, Eads, 215 pounds. 290, they got a guy, and there he is squirting through, and is gonna get a couple of yards there as there's a little pushback. Number 72 for the Tractors.
There's a play.
Hamoud Sabah. Getting pushed around by Nick Edney. Edney, the captain for the Cougars, comes in 6'2", 265. He's had his hands full tonight. There we go. Wouldn't be a complete play without a penalty of some kind, and this looks
that's at least the fourth personal foul against Fordson tonight.
Well, that's at least the fourth in about the last six plays. You count the end of the first half when they went 45 yards on three of them. The Cougars went 45 yards forward on three personal foul penalties.
You mentioned the offensive line. Edney's the center. White and Patterson are the guards. Briscoe and Covington are the tackles for the Garden City Cougars, dressed in the dark blue uniforms, orange numbers, black pants. Everybody in tight, one receiver close to this sideline. And he's a decoy, a little handoff. And along the line of scrimmage, Woods carries and doesn't get anything.
Not a lot of running room along that line of scrimmage right there. Had we detailed that in the first half, there's a lot of beef on both sides of the ball, and the Cougars are just not able to get any running lanes in there. As DeMarquez Woods tried to find something off the right side and was hammered home. Brings up second down and 10. Cougars trailing. Need to get something going here in the second half.
Man in motion again. Becker is stopped. I want to tell you, the line that Fortson's up, they got 290, 270, 260, 280. And Woods, he took it. He's gained a yard. It's been almost all Woods here in the second quarter. They've run him four times up the line for maybe 3 yards.
Third and 11. This is a big play. Everything bunched in, trying to get some room as Tinsley comes out, but it's once again handed off to Woods, trying to have some power football there, Ted.
Well, the only man in the near vicinity, there's another flag, and this could give Garden City a first down if it's against the defense.
Dead ball foul, unsportsmanlike conduct at number 52, Blue. It'll be a 15-yard penalty, fourth down.
No, they didn't get any yardage, and then the unsportsmanlike conduct. This is getting to be really chippy.
Well, Nick Edney down there, we've called his number a few times tonight, Ted. He's done a great job in there battling the Giants along with the other guys you talked about. We know Chase Patterson's in there, and we're going to get some of those other names. But that time just got the best of him. You see him right there lining up. He's the right guard.
Fourth down and 22.
Fourth and 22. Garden City to punt. The receiver is standing back here on the. And this one was short and shanked. And Garden City is going to give up the ball. Where are they going to put it? At the 34-yard line, 33-yard line?
Yeah, it looks like it was there. It was a line drive kick, and that it came off the foot. I think that punter's number 81 in there, maybe, Cameron Walter.
Well, the ball came off and just went straight out of bounds. It wouldn't have, even if they downed it, it wouldn't have been a first down. So, Fordson with great field position at the 31-yard line. Looks like the starters are coming all back out. Fordson running out of a spread. Which back has come out here? Can you see? Is that Baydoun or?
At the bottom of the screen.
No, it looks like number three in there. And he's great. No, it's not.
That's Baydoun.
Baydoun gets inside the 20, picks up about 10, maybe 11. And it's going to be a first down just like that. Right in the red zone again here at the 9:23 mark, leading 34 to nothing. Baydoun in the backfield.
It's actually Abdul Aziz Alahanik.
Alahanik,
number 27. Alahanik, he's got the ball again, Ted.
And he gets to hit right at the line of scrimmage, but falls forward for two. Alahanik is the fourth back that's been in the backfield here. Is that a new quarterback in there? Looks like 15.
15, new quarterback, Mokled. Ahmed Mokled. So we've got a whole different cast of offensive players in for Fordson right now as head coach over there. Fawad Zabin is emptying out his bench right now, Ted, at 34 to nothing here in the second half. Gonna get some guys some playing time.
Mokled, the big hole, cuts across the fives, high stepping it. And it looks like they said touchdown. 27.
Alhanik there. Abdul Aziz Alhanik. Now, Honig, you know, really, that was where the Fordson started the game off, Ted. Remember when they ran Badoon up the center the first few plays, then they never went back to it. Now here they are opening up
the second half right up the center, 19-yard run. Right between the tackles, Phil, and nothing fancy. And let's see if they can pull this extra point off without a penalty. And the penalty is up and good. So it's 41-0. And you explain what that means, Phil.
Well, that means we're going to have a running clock from this point forward. So the clock does not stop. Once the ball is put into play, the only time is going to be an official timeout or the timeout called by the team. So it means if there's an incomplete pass, the clock keeps running. Means if a player goes out of bounds, the clock keeps running. Means if there's a first down, they usually don't stop the clock to reset the chains. There'll be no stopping of the clock now with the 35-point lead. Actually, it's 41 in this case, but it just requires 35 points and to be in the second half, and it calls for a running clock. So as soon as the ball's kicked off, the clock will not stop unless the officials or Coach Scott Murray or Fawad Zaban calls the timeout.
Well, you just saw Scott Murray, Coach Scott Murray for Garden City on the screen right there as Fordson comes out here.
Castonier's deep along with Tinsley. Castonier's been the yeoman back there.
Well, side A, the number 14, the kicker, is left-footed, and when he approaches the ball, he's just continues to kick it to his right side, and that's where Castonia is. Has been there all night. He's standing on the five, and the ball is up in the air, and Castonia cuts inside. He takes the ball, cuts across the 20. He tries to go the other direction, and he's greeted by a fleet of tractors right on the 21-yard line.
Well, there you go. Sometimes, you know, when you're running the kicks back like that, Ted, it's just better to, you know, kind of, you know, keep your head of steam going right there. That time, Castonier came to a complete stop, tried to reverse his field, but by then there were about five tractors right on top of him, and he had nowhere to go. So Cougars are going to start right there at the 22 as the clock continues to run now, as you'll see the clock not being stopped except for the official timeout or one of the coaches.
Well, there is one other way. If the timekeeper, Coach Chris Griffith, hiccups and accidentally shuts it off, that could happen too. Hey, guess what? Hey, we have two receivers out now in the beer formation. Quick pass, wide open over his head as the wide receiver, Rayburn, was 5 yards away from anybody. If he hits it, he's still running.
Well, there you go. That's a lot of times a way. If you're not going to run a spread formation, then you better start throwing deep, or at least just do anything you can to spread out the defense, Ted. And that's what exactly did not happen in the first half, and the 10 men in the box just sort of ruled for the tractors on the defensive side of things.
Same formation, going for the same play, this time inside, broken up nicely by the defender.
Ghalib, Nassar Ghalib. Ghalib got a nice hand in there. That was a terrific defensive play. That was a slant pass right there. Rayburn cut inside, and Ghalib was right there and just poked the ball down.
Well, I don't even think the first time they knew Rayburn was out there, because they've only been putting one receiver outside. Here comes a man in motion, hands it out to Woods up the middle, and that play, I think Fordson has seen that play before, because it is just nothing is happening with that Woods up the middle play.
Marquez Woods, number one on the carry.
Absolutely nothing on that play, and it's fourth down.
I think you detailed it, Ted. In that type of offense, you know, if you're not getting the lanes to run in, then what you really need is the big bruiser right there. I mean, somebody that can really get past the first and second hits you know, and Woods, to his credit, has done a terrific job, but he just gets stacked up and he doesn't have the power, you know, in his legs to keep going.
Ground ball to the punter. He gets the kick off, hits it to 45, taking it to 40, crosses over the 45, 50, gets over the 45, 40, 35, 30, cuts 25, going outside, got one man to beat, and he gets shoved out of bounds. And what a return as that ball was taken on the 35-yard. They're going to say touchdown.
65-yard punt return by Al-Hanak. Al-Hanak. 65-yard touchdown for a punt return right there. And that's Abdul Aziz Al-Hanak, you know.
Watch this replay. As it was a ground ball to the punter, winner gets it off. It's going to be hitting, little bounce, takes a nice hop. He beats number six, McGraw, and then he's got a big, huge lanes. He's got a blocker there. He picks up a blocker, comes out to across the 10, one man to beat, and he gets shoved inside the pylon, touchdown.
Nice play right there by Brandon Mitchum, you know, coming right across the field, and that kick is going to be no good, but Mitchum did a great job to try and close the gap on him right there. Right to the pylon he went with it and got into the end zone. So the kick being no good is now 47-0.
Oh.
For the Tractors.
Well, Garden City is going to be playing again next week against Redford Union. Redford Union picked up a victory here a week ago, which was the first victory they've gotten since 2013. And down the road, Wayne Memorial, new coach over at Wayne Memorial, whole new staff, and they're looking for their first victory in the last two or three years. Some big teams. We also mentioned Canton playing great ball, Saline playing good ball, and some good football on Friday night. Like you always say, $5, it's a great show.
Absolutely, and you know, we know about the Tractors from last year, 13-0, went deep into the playoffs and lost to Cass Tech. I was at that game. Mike Weber, the great Mike Weber, he really single-handedly took over that game late, scored late in that game, and they held off the Tractors, and they marched on to the semifinals. But this Tractor team's got a lot of experience. They really play disciplined football as far as not the penalties, though, but as far as their offense. Estonier.
Across the 20, 25, 30, knocked out of bounds around the 31-yard line, and that's where Garden City has taken possession between the 20 and 35-yard line most of the night, as opposed to Fordson, who have started somewhere between their own 45 and the Cougar 45 most of the night. So the field position has definitely been in favor of Fordson all night long, and they've taken advantage of it as we go inside the 5-minute mark as Scott Murray sends his troops out there. Becker still at quarterback, yes he is. They're still in the veer, they've got in everybody tight, one receiver on the far side, and let's see if they've got something up their sleeve. They have been very, very conservative here in the third quarter.
You got Tinsley, Spizak, and then Woods in the backfield. Tinsley number 9 and Spizak.
Number 11, both on the wings. Tinsley in motion. He takes a pitch, trying to get outside. He's got a blocker trailing. He does get around. His speed gets him across the 40. Almost to the first down marker. Probably picked up 8. Tinsley on a nice gain. And I think that's the first time they've run that play that they haven't had a holding going on that way. And that's an improvement right now.
Well, exactly. And then you want to see him get further outside like that and then try to turn the corner right there. That's where they've been picking up their yardage, not in the center between the tackles, Ted.
Now they come back the other way. Hand it off to Woods, and Woods is just smacked right at the 40. And like I said, they keep running that play to Woods. And one time he got 5 yards on it. The rest, it's been a lost cause.
Well, I was seeing Iyad right there, just wrapped him right up. You know, he just, smelled the play out all the way. And now that's going to bring up third down and three.
Third down and three. Beer formation, two receivers spread out wide. Back to pass. Throws it inside off the hands. Tinsley off right off his hands, and that's the worst place to hit a receiver.
Well, that time he went up for it. You know, that's where you really need those soft hands right there, Ted. If you watch that play unfold, they talk about a receiver having soft hands. That's exactly a prime example where he needed the soft hands to just cradle that ball right in. Fourth down and three, they're going to go for it.
Well, they have to go for it. You can't, they can't give the ball back. They got to try for the first down here. They need three. Man in motion. The blitz is on. Becker is just comes. The blitz was on number five or six. Mohammed
Hamka.
And I don't think anybody touched him.
Well, they're learning their timing right there. That was a perfect job of timing. Hamka comes from the safety position, Ted, and he just knew right where the gap was, and he timed it perfectly right there. And absolutely no chance for Kyle Becker to do anything. And it looked like it was going to be an option play by Becker rolling to his left. He had his players in position to pitch to or take it himself, but he never got an opportunity. The ball goes over on downs to Fordson.
There it is. My Fordson lineup just took off. Number 10 has got wide open. He's tackled in here at the 15. Is that is number 10, right?
Number 10. We
have Dawkins Johnson. Johnson is the sixth back that's been back there.
Jaquez Johnson.
Macklid is the quarterback, and he handed it off to Johnson. Johnson had a gaping hole. Gets inside to the 15-yard line, first and 10 from the 15. Handed off to Johnson again. He comes out wide, down inside the 10, fumbles, but out of bounds. And at the 104 mark, we got a flag on the play.
Holding. Offense number 70, 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul.
It looks like they just have a whole stable of backs down there just raring to go, and they just unleash them, send them in, and start them up, and they run.
Yeah, they're getting large gaping holes, but it's been a lot of, we've talked about discipline, but obviously I'm not referring to the penalties, but maybe it's more diversity is the better way of describing how Fordson has been on offense. They've had quite a bit of diverse plays. They've thrown a lot of different formations, like they're in a different formation here with three wide receivers, spreading the Cougars out, finding the running lanes, quick hitters. They've had a power football, Ted. They've really done it in a variety of ways.
Well, the clock is ticking. We're under 50 seconds here to go in the third. Back to pass as a quarterback, and he misses. Basically, the wide receiver came in too far, and he threw him where he was, and by the time the ball got there, he wasn't there anymore.
That was Abdelatif out there. That was a flanker screen is what that was, Ted. It was set up nicely, but the ball was delivered too high, but the Cougars were closing in on it, so they weren't fooled, Ted. Had it been a completed pass, it probably would have gone for a little bit.
Let's see if they even get a playoff here. We're up to 8 seconds, and Fordson is not going to get a playoff as they walk. They're leading 47-0 here as the clock waits for the gun. And there it is, and it's the end of the third quarter. And we've got one quarter to go, and the Cougars are on the short end of a 47-0 score. Hey, Sports Menu. I want to tell you there, if you've never been there, Phil, the food is wonderful over at Sports Menu. It's right over there on the corner of Middle Belt in Maplewood. Wonderful food, great atmosphere. Great waitresses, friendly waitresses, and we recommend if you got nothing going on, You looking for dinner? Head over to the sports venue, even after the game.
Absolutely. Just what you see right there at the sports venue. I see they have trivia nights up there. I've seen where they've organized Tiger game junkets down there. You know, real progressive. They're always doing something fun up there. You know, they'll have different theme parties going on up there. You really like to see that on the local level because it really brings them out. You know, and well-deserved to go into the sports venue and have a good time.
I recommend the nachos.
All right. Nice, beautiful picture right there. Fabulous job by our camera crew. I know we've got Evan Chapman, and you're going to have a whole host of others right there. Be responsible.
Well, my man Christian's in the truck, and as long as Christian's around, things seem to be good.
Of course, you're talking about the producer, Christian Gibbons.
Oh, yeah, he got promoted. He used to be only a director. Now he's a big producer. Maklik throws it. He stepped inside the coverage. Nice pro-type move right there. Looked a little like Tom Brady, and he had pressure. He just stepped right. Look how big that line is. Look how big that line is.
Yeah, they have been very imposing. They've opened up a lot of holes tonight. The Cougars have done a really great job at, you know, going toe-to-toe with them, Ted. But it's been the variety of formations, and it's been the real intricate offense that really has kept the Cougars off guard. Physically, they've really held up nicely physically. There's the beach ball going on, and we got Jeff Sorensen and Jake Mahan. And Evan Chapman on cameras. To the corner to the right there.
Throw to the pylon. You know, I know Evan's where, which camera is he on? Because I know he's over there announcing the game on the headsets over there. Noah, we got Noah. And Noah, we're not sure how to pronounce your name here. Is it French? Is it Peugeot? Or Pigott? Somebody help us out here, Noah. Pigott.
Doing the replays tonight, and he's done a fabulous job bringing us the replays. Been right on the spot with the replays. Fabule, as they say.
Pigot. If he's French, it's Pigot.
And Fabule.
Here we got a field goal attempt here. The ball's down. It's up, and it is good. So your score now is after a 30-yard field goal is 50-0. And tonight's, I think one of the tapes, if you're the coaching staff, you take the tape and you thank the cameraman for taping it, and you walk it over to the trash barrel, and you say, you know what, there's nothing we can learn from this tape.
Well, this is where, you know, when you're Coach Murray, you do something creative with the tape. You know, like you dig a hole out there at the 50-yard line and bury it, you know, and everybody takes a chance.
So it fertilizes Scott Murray's garden. Or you take the tape and you color it different colors and decorate your Christmas tree with it.
There you go.
But the last thing you want to do is look through this again.
Yeah, exactly. There really isn't a lot.
Well, I think most of the time this is digital now. So all you have to do is take the tape, stick it in your computer, and hit delete.
That's it.
And you hope the FBI never cancels, gets your computer and watches this tape.
Got Colton Henderson doing graphics for us, doing a fabulous job on the graphics. And of course, our director tonight, what can you say? In the director's chair, filling the big shoes, Zach King, doing a fabulous job.
I never
job.
Heard that, Zach. Is it Furby or Feebu or what? What
well,
do they call
it
this
was
guy?
Furby when he was on camera, but now that he's a director, it's Mr. Zach King.
All right.
So he's been doing a yeoman's job down there. This was high, end over end, drops him right back to the goal line, Ted, and here's sprint to the finish.
He got a big return here over the 435. Castoni.
No, that was Hunter Damon.
Oh, we got all kinds of substitutes coming in here. It's what do they call it? Mop-up time at the 9:49 clock running, 50-0. It was 34-0 at halftime.
their score, created the running clock, and I guess I'll stand corrected. They do stop it after a touchdown, but that's pretty much the only time other than official timeouts, injury timeouts, and coaches' timeouts. But the running clock since early in the third quarter when it went over 35 points.
Hands in motion, hands out to Woods, and I don't know. If I want to run that play now, I'm going to get the biggest guy on the sideline, anybody over 250, hand him the ball and see if he can bust through the line, because Woods is not going anywhere on that play.
Well, it's been a stone wall up there, and this one's pitched out deep.
And broke a tackle, picked up three yards on the pitch.
Devin Dodd, you know, takes a nice deep pitch right there. And I've been calling for that all night, Ted. You know, you've got it. If you're not going to spread it in the formation, then spread it by pitching the ball out deep like that.
Dodd, that's his second carry tonight. And he actually was hit and broke a tackle and fell backwards for a couple yards there. And now we have two receivers out wide, a little more spread formation. Here and back to pass is Becker. He cranks and throws it across the middle. Caught at the 50-yard line. Gets tackled down at the 41 on a little play where you just bring the receiver inside of the defender. And Becker threw a bullet, hit him right in the numbers, and picked up big yardage. Nice first down. And Garden City is now inside Fordson territory.
That was Quante Jenkins, and he's a big target right there, Ted. And, you know, that would have been nice to see him early on like that. He's the one you want going across the middle for you. You know, that you get a big guy like him going across the middle, and that'll start loosening things up there, too.
The little dive play in between the guards. Nothing going. Lost yardage for Garden City. You know, it's time. Yeah, that play keeps the defense honest, but not in the fourth quarter.
Tinsley now quarterback.
Back to pass. Tinsley rifles it, and that was stepped inside the receiver, intercepted by Fordson.
Sheriff Moussad. Ball was thrown right to him. Just made the comment that Tinsley was in at quarterback replacing Kyle Becker right there. In that time, right, you know, the receiver and the defender were in the same spot, and I think that Tinsley wanted to get the ball more to the receiver side. Instead, he threw it inside, trying to go inside shoulder, and it went right into the defender.
Well, when the receiver turns in and stops, then the corner can step in front of him. You almost want to hit him on that play coming across or turning into the middle. You want to hit him on the go. If he stops, a good corner will just step in. Here's a first down play for 10 yards. Johnson's still in at the back, number 10. He came in on the last series. The clock is racing down. It's down to 6:04. Your score is out of control, 50-0. And Fordson has the ball. And I think that was the worst field position Fordson has picked up the ball tonight. And my partner, Phil, is mesmerized by, I'm not sure what, but he looked like you were in a trance there, Phil.
Well, you know, it's just like you're just speechless at this point in the evening. You know, you don't used to call too many 50-0 football games. And
a little out, overthrown the receiver.
And that's normally a time you see the clock stop, but once it gets over 35 points, the clock continues to run at a time like that. So Fordson still, you know, they're onto their second quarterback, Ted, and they're still showing, you know, they're still showing a variety of offense. They're still giving these guys a good opportunity to move the football and some quality playing time in.
Second quarterback, but all their second team skill players are in, and their fifth tailback's in. Johnson, he gets the ball. He's across the 50, over the 45, still on his feet. He's breaks loose and he's going home. They race down the sidelines and it's 56-0. Johnson cut across the formation, duked one player, hit to the sidelines. and there was nothing between him but air and grass and chalk.
Well, at that point, he bounced it out there nicely, got his legs going, had his shoulders always squared up right there, Ted. You know, he never really turned sideways or anything, was a strictly north and south job of running once he broke to the outside, showed a terrific burst of speed down the sideline, and the Cougars just couldn't catch him. And he's probably, the fifth back that we've seen in Fordson tonight. And impressive as this kick breaks down, and it's going to be a two-pointer.
And it's now 58-0. And well, the only thing Fordson can do now is call the JV team over here to run the clock out.
Right there, you're noticing.
He broke a tackle right there. It could have been stopped way back up the field, but he ran through a tackle and outraced 16 to the end zone.
Dylan White, you know, number 16 in hot pursuit right there. But, you know, when you've got a running back and you see the goal line, you know, and you see those pylons down there, Ted, I got a feeling that you got an extra bit of burner in you.
Well, you know, Johnson just comes in here for the last two series, and he has close to probably 80 yards rushing here in two series.
Yeah, absolutely. Jacquez Johnson, you know, your fifth back right now. And we're going to see this formation. We've seen it several times tonight, Ted. Kick formation. Cougars receiving a kickoff. There's the Cougar Crazies are still here.
Well, they're having fun. They had the beach balls going, and that's why they call them crazy. They have fun no matter where they are.
And that's what it should be, too. Get out here, you know, they go to school with these kids, are in classes with them. There's nobody out here that's done anything but play hard. And, boy, there's the something we haven't seen in a while, Ted.
Dead ball foul on Fordson. The ready-to-play signal, the ready-to-play whistle was not blown. 5-yard penalty, re-kick.
Well, basically what they did is they got over-anxious and they kicked the ball before the reps are. We're anxious as we go to the two-minute warning here with 2:12 as Garden City is going to get the ball. And
I just want to know what the signal is for that, Ted, because I don't think I've ever heard that penalty called in my entire life.
There was no signal. He just called the penalty. No signal.
Like, you know, I've just never heard of that, that you kicked the ball before we blew the whistle
that
you could kick the ball.
Over-anxious on Fordson.
I don't know what you would call it, but I don't know what the signal was for that, but they went deep into the book of penalties for that one.
Okay, who did they sneak in back there?
That's Woods, and there's another penalty flag thrown into that tackle, Ted, so.
Well, if the referees are kind, they'll take a long time here sorting this penalty out, and that will be our last play of the game.
Martez Woods, I think, was on that return right
during
there.
The return, blocking the back on Garden City, 32 blue, well, 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul, first down.
I don't know what Coach Murray's going to do, but I'll either hand it off to Woods or take a knee here, and let's go home.
In the final minute of a 58-0 game, and there's
Scott Murray, though. He'll make him work on this play. He'll work on something.
There it is. Now we can see, and you know, it's actually, I keep getting that one. That's number 7 right there, Hunter Damon. And there it is, flying in at the last minute.
And there was a little exchange of pleasantries after that, and guess what?
Dead ball foul, false start on the offense.
Yeah, it's 28 seconds to go. And I don't know, we haven't kept track of how many penalties there are, but it's got to be close to a Guinness World Record.
Well, I'm sure that they have a checklist of penalties that they have not called off, and they got that one in
there. I think that's going to be it, Phil. Both teams at 7 seconds are walking out the field. Little shaking hands there. Little sportsmanship going on in the middle of the field. Both teams across the middle. That's the end of the game, and I want to tell you, mercifully, the game is over, and it was all Fordson. Garden City crossed the midfield twice, once with penalties, and the other was here late in the fourth quarter. Fordson had great field position all night long. And just, you know, I didn't use it all night long, but basically Fordson's big uglies beat the heck out of our big uglies tonight and won the line of scrimmage on both sides. And your final score is 58-0, bro.
Well, exactly, and now it's just a matter of the great Dan York, executive producer, Zach King, the director, and there's Christian Gibbons,
senior
associate, you know.
I thought he was only a junior associate.
Evan Chapman. Let's just get all the names here of the great guys that bring this. There's Jeff Sorensen, of course. What a fabulous job he did tonight. And Jake Mahan. I mean, he was steady as could be on the camera. And there's Noah
Pigeot.
And then Colton Henderson on graphics. Noah Pigeot was doing replays. They did a fabulous job. It was a great, great event brought to you by Omni Edition Sports Television. Ted.
All right, we're going to, if I'm not mistaken, we're going to be back here next week. Garden City's going to have a chance to redeem themselves against Redford Union. Phil, I'm planning on being back. You coming back?
Absolutely. I wouldn't miss it for the world, and don't you either. It's only $5 to get in.
All right, 58-0 is your final score. Let's forget about it and enjoy our rest of our Friday evening for our entire staff. I'm Ted Fournier. He's Phil Henry. We'll see you next time on Omni Edition Sports. Good night.